بس يلا بينا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله الحمد لله that we came today praying Salat al-Subh in the house of Allah, and we asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our Salah and to protect us for today and for every day, provide us with all the provisions, you know. Alhamdulillah. Subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah wallahu akbar. Allahumma ighfir lana, Allahumma arhamna, Allahumma arzuqna.
Amin.
Allahumma ihdina fima tuhib lima tuhibbu wa tardah.
Amin.
فمن يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. Where were we last time? We were with the jinn, Mr. Zawba'a, right? Mr. Zawba'a, when he came in and shook hands with Rasulullah, and he brought all the people from Iraq, all the jinn people from Iraq, to come and meet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so they can declare their Islam.
Nobody was there from Kurdish.
From where?
Kurdish.
From Nineveh.
From Kurdistan.
Kurdistan.
Omar was your.
We like all jinn from Iraq.
Your Qareen was there. Yes. Your Qareen was there.
We are jinn before.
Yes.
That is Shia.
Yeah, and I still have those things. Okay. So anyway. They know they came, all of them, okay, to meet Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Mr. Zawba'a, he told them, Ya Rasulullah, okay, I brought all the jinn people from my country, all right, to come and yubayyuk. So where are they? Rasulullah told them, where are they? He said, well, they are at Jabal al-Juhun, okay, over there.
Yeah,
shall I bring them? He said, no, just leave them there. I'm going to go to them.
Yeah.
See, أخلاق الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, he goes to the person. Okay, you know, إحنا we have to make big deal to meet somebody. Anyway, so رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he just went in his way to Jabal al-Juhun so he can meet all those people, and they says they are about 20,000 jinn.
MashaAllah.
Okay, it's only from one country. All right. And this is what Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was telling us. That's narrated by him. So everything we're going to tell from now on is going to be Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. He's describing the meeting and what he saw and everything. And he said, maybe there are 20,000. Of course, he didn't see them. Rasulullah probably told him later on. Okay. Anyway. So when they, both of them, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, their way, and they came close to the Jabal al-Juhun, okay, Rasulullah told Ibn Mas'ud, he put a lion on the floor, on the ground, and he said, Ya Abdullah, you step here behind this lion, don't cross it, okay, I don't want you to cross it because I don't want you to get scared, but I will go. So brave, okay, so brave. He's protected by Allah.
What is it, Dr.? Because Abdullah Mas'ud cannot see the jinn, and jinn, yes, they are from the flame of the fire.
Yes.
So he might be, he can step on one of them and he can harm them. Also Abdullah too, because now are stronger than jinn. But that's why this is your line, don't cross this man. Stay here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, he doesn't see them. Yes, that's true. Yes. See, what's good about you sitting next to me?
I'm learning from you, Dr.
No, it's okay. Okay. So Rasulullah approached them. The leader of the jinn met him, okay, and I think the leader this time was, his name was Amr.
That's good.
Okay. Well, how do you know about this name? Allahu alam. Okay, people saying that his name was Amr. Okay.
Okay.
So Rasulullah sat down and shook hands with everyone of them. Okay. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud describing, he said, then I saw all of a sudden clouds coming, clouds one after the other, whole bunch of clouds. That's all what he sees, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Okay, clouds. Okay. قال كأنهم الزلط الزط. الزط clouds كانهم and كانهم الزط. الزط means ليس عليهم ثياب. They are really naked. Okay, something naked. Okay, they're suit, they're black. Okay, يركب بعضهم فوق بعض. Okay, coming on top of each. Would you imagine? Okay, let me give you an example. Okay, those jinn came. Okay, and they were crowding on top of each other. They wanted. If I tell you, for example, okay, it's just hypothetical. Okay, over there. Over there, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is standing by. What are we going to be doing? We're going to all rush, and we're going to crowd, and probably we're going to jump on top of each other because we want to see him, okay? Yeah. Because too many people, okay? If you're going to just walk slowly or walk, you're not going to see, but you're going to jump on the top of the shoulder of the people in front. Yes. That's why yes. They came in, okay?
The Quran so, said that?
Yes, we're coming to that. Okay. Lubada.
Yes.
Okay, yes.
Yeah.
So he saw the clouds, you know, like coming on top of each other, Okay. حتى اقتربوا من رسول الله. They came to close to the Rasulullah, and then Abdullah Masood didn't see anything afterwards because they just obscured the view from him. Okay. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى وأنه لما قام عبد الله يدعوه كادوا يكونون عليه لبدا.
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 لبدا. لبدا. Okay. لبدا. لبدا means crowded group. Crowded. لبدا. لبدا. Like لبدا بتاعت لبدا أسد. The lion. Okay. The hair. The fur around him. That's called لبدا. Okay. لبدا. Right. So it's crowded on top of each other. لبدا. لبدا. Okay. So the lion's mane, which is the hair around his head, okay, it's called it's full of the fur, the hair around him. Okay. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam تجمع الجن حوله يقرأ القرآن. Rasulullah was reciting Quran and the jinn are around him, and they came close to him. Okay. And he didn't know that they are really close to him. Still didn't see them. He didn't see them. So Jibril came in and he told him, "قل أوحي إلي أنه استمع نفر من الجن." So Jibril is telling Rasulullah a revelation or a verse to tell him that a jinn are around you and they are listening to what you are reciting. Okay, this is just. Listen to this story, you know, by your heart. Don't use your brain in it because you cannot really imagine those things. Okay, so it's just by your feeling.
We believe it, doctor.
Yeah, of course. Oh yeah, I know.
Just feeling. We believe.
But don't. Yeah, we believe. But don't say how come he didn't see them. Did he see them or not? How did they look like? We don't know.
This is what I explained this last night about the Quran. You cannot use al-aql and you neglect al-naql. Both they are together.
Right.
Al-aql and al-naql.
Right.
Don't neglect your aql and use it with the naql. There is no contradiction.
Right.
We believe. Quran said, khalas, we believe. That's it.
Done. Yeah. We believe in the Quran, but yes. try to scrutinize the image or the picture in front of you is going to be very difficult for you.
Quran
said that. Okay. قل أوحي إلي أنه استمع نفر من الجن. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed.
Yes.
So Abdullah Mas'ud, he says, Rasul spent the whole night with them, okay, until dawn, until Fajr. And what he says is, I didn't see anything except blackness, black, dark on top of dark on top of dark. Okay, okay. حتى حجبوا ما بيني وبين رسول الله إلى السماء. All dark and clouds and everything all the way up to the sky. And then when the dawn came in the morning, okay, I heard Abdullah Masood saying, narrated. Abdullah Masood said, when the morning came in, okay, I heard أصوات عزيز and zzz, okay, and the clouds start going away one after the other, one after the other, clearing the way and everything. But he hears عزيز, okay, and they shook hands with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Mr. Amr, okay, shook hands with Rasulullah, all right, okay, and Amr really liked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was keep holding his hand, he doesn't want to leave his hand, okay, and Mr. Amr, do you know how old was he? 800 years.
I believe.
His. Yeah, I saw one here upstairs when we, Dr. I'm doing Rukhya for the gin, was possessing somebody there, which I didn't believe it until I saw it, really. Those are existing, you guys, okay? I mean, everybody look in the mirror, okay, see your gin, whether it's still there or not, anyway. No, we were asking him, you know, when the doctor was making the Rukhya, we were asking him, how old are you? He said, 750 years.
Yes.
750 years, this is an average. There is more than that.
Right.
Okay, they live. But they have their own kingdom. Like us, they have male, female, and they get married, and they have nikah, and they have fornication, the kids, and they have everything, and laws, and everything. The same like us, exactly. Yeah. Okay. Anyway, then Rasulullah said to Amr, the Amir al-Jinn, okay, اذهب يا عمر, just to go, فإن الله سيمد في عمرك وتموت في أرض فلا. He told him, just to go, and Allah will extend your life. You will live long life, but you're gonna die in the desert. You're gonna die in the desert, okay? And ويدفنك خير رجل في أمتي آنذاك. I don't know who's that gonna do that. I really don't know.
Subhanallah.
He just go, and Allah will extend your life to a very long one. Okay, and but you end up by dying in the فلاح اللي هي الصحراء, the desert. Okay. يقول ابن مسعود حتى إذا رأيت النبي سمعته يحدث أقواما لا أراهم. He heard them talking to people. He doesn't see them, okay? And telling them, Rasulullah telling them, but that's what Abdullah Mas'ud saying. He said, I heard Rasulullah talking to people and telling them, you know, لكم كل عظم وراوث. You will have every bones and rawas. You know, rawas, disposals of the human being or the animals and all of those, or the things you throw it away. Okay, you don't eat it, throw it away. So he told those group, you're gonna have every bones, all the bones, and all the disposals of the human being. What the human being threw away is gonna be your food later on. So Abdullah Mas'ud, he said, well, I heard you, Rasulullah, you're saying that لَكُمْ كُلُّ عَصْمٍ وَرَوْسِ. What do you mean by that? He said, those are, لَكُمْ كُلُّ عَصْمٍ means when we eat something and it has bones in it, and we throw the bones, okay? Don't crush the bone, don't dirty it, just throw it away, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put around the bones or put meat around the bones, and that's gonna be the food for the jinn later on. Okay? And the rawas also, okay? Everything you dispose it, you know, like, you know, ishrab, batikh, whatever, anything you throw it away, okay? Allah will make it alaf, will make it like fertilizers for, or food for their baha'im or whatever it is, okay? So, that's why when Rasulullah said, when you go to the bathroom, their bathroom, not now we have all bidets and stuff like that, their bathroom, and don't clean yourself with a piece of bone, okay? Yeah. Because that bone is going to be, eventually, is going to be food for those jinn.
That's right.
Okay, so it's, again, respect to that the jinn kingdom, okay? And when Abdullah Mas'ud saw Rasulullah and telling him that, and he was shaking hand with him, I said, I heard this and was holding, Ya Rasulullah, your hand is so hot, what's the matter with you? He said, well, that's from shaking hand with those jinn, Khwanak al-Jinn, they are made out of smokeless fire, marjan min nar, okay? They are hot, okay? So that's what, okay? فهو سلامهم علي وهم يودعوني مرتحلين الى البلاد. That's why my hand is really hot because I was shaking hand with all of those things and they are really made out of smokeless fire. Okay, anyway, so we explained that why is the hand is hot, why are the azm and rawas, okay? And this is only that azm and rawas, this is only for the jinn and muslimin. Allah is going to do that for the jinn and the Muslim jinn, okay? They will take our things which we threw it away, it's going to make it good for the Muslim jinn. The ولاد الكلب الجيني تانيين they don't need any thing from Allah. Okay. Anyway. Okay. And Abdullah Mas'ud continue to say, ثم أخذني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأراني مباركهم وآثار نيرانهم. He took me and he said, okay, here they were sitting and here is the fire they lit fire and they prepared the food for themselves to eat while they are in the presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay. Now, let's go back again. This is actually the meeting of Rasulullah with the jinn and how they declared Islam and, you know, whole bunch of them. And back again, remember when Rasulullah came back from Taif and he wanted to come back to Mecca, but he was afraid because Quraysh now has a bad signal about him that he was went to Thaqif, Qabila Thaqif, and asking them to yunsuru against Quraysh. So he was afraid to go there and he went to one guy by the name Mut'am ibn Adi. He was kafir, Mut'am ibn Adi, but he awah, he ajaru. He said, you're going to be under my protection. Okay, so he went there and he was under his Mut'am ibn Adi protection. Now you can see Rasulullah in this condition. Now so much calamity, so much hardship, so much difficult life, he said. Okay, he's really disappointed. He's really broken hearted. Okay. Allah wants to console him. Allah wants to make him happy. Allah wants to give him something better than what he saw from Quraysh or what he experienced in al-Ta'if. Okay, so Allah, as if Allah telling him, Ya Muhammad, this as if Allah, Ya Muhammad, okay, إذا كان ما لقيته يا رسول الله من أهل الأرض فتعال وانظر إلى مكانتك عند أهل السماء. Allah is sort of inspiring to Muhammad. He said, you're sad. Is this is what you, if you think this is what you saw from the people of that earth, come to me. I'll show you what's your position, how valuable, how great you are with the people of Ahl al-Sama. So it means that what? This is Bushara ila Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for the journey or the trip of Al-Isra wa al-Mi'raj. Okay? Now, brothers, man, we're going to talk about Isra wa al-Mi'raj now. Okay? Now. Okay. So, Rihlat al-Isra wa al-Mi'raj. First of all, we have to believe that this is a fact. It's not a dream. It's not imagination. It is a fact. It happened. That's number one. Number two, that rahla was actually qabla al-hijra, okay, by 1 year. So it's actually in the 12 year of the al-ba'asa, okay, aw fi al-'am al-'ashir, the 10 or the 12 years, okay. They say it's either the 10 of al-ba'asa aw the 12 year. Before al-Hijra, 1 year, 2 years, something like that. That was Rahlat al-Isra wal-Mi'raj. The idea is Allah is consoling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, okay, to take him from his sadness and his upset from the people, what he saw from the people, just to make him feel better and he show him beautiful things, okay? Okay, anyway. That trip was in the seventh day after he came back from Taif, after 1 week, after 7 days, that's actually started the Rahlat al-Isra wal-Mi'raj. Okay. Now, يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى اوكي بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم في سورة الإسراء فيرس نمبر 1 سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير. سو الله يسد سبحان الله الذي أسرى بعبده. Let's stop at the two words سبحان and عبده. سبحان is actually a word for التعظيم. Glorifying سبحان. You don't say سبحان أحمد. No, سبحان الله. That's actually it's a measure or it's an indication of التعظيم والقدرة. Okay. Only Allah will tell anything Allah is doing it, say سبحان. So actually this is actually للتعظيم. And it's also it's for something really beyond expectation, out of you know something nobody can do it. I guess so. It's a miracle. Okay, that's also indication for a miracle. Okay, and if al-Isra al-Mi'raj, like some people say, it was a dream. So what's so miracle about a dream? No. The miraculous thing about the rihla that Rasulullah was being taken by himself, by his body and his soul, as he is taken to al-Masjid al-Aqsa, then urja bihi ila al-samaa' as-sab'a. Okay, so that's an i'jaz, subhan. Okay, bi'abdihi, asra bi'abdihi. Abdihi means soul and body. That's the word عبدي, boss. So exactly, he really, يعني if somebody was there in where he was, okay, while he's in the trip, he's not there. All his body went. See, is that clear? All right. Where was he, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? At night, he was sleeping at the house of Umm Hani'. The sister of Ali ibn Abi Talib. So she is his cousin. He was sleeping. He used to like her so much. Okay. And she is his cousin. And she was at that night over there. All right. At he was there over there. Okay. So while he was sleeping, okay, Jibreel came to him. To Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, okay, and called him and he said, Ya Muhammad, get ready to meet Allah. Beautiful message. Ya Muhammad, he woke him up and he said, Ya Muhammad, get ready to meet Allah. فإن الله يدعوك لزيارته في السماء. Allah is inviting you to meet him in the heaven. Okay? فإذا كانت الطائف وقريش أغلقت أبوابها في وشك فها هو الله عز وجل. So he's telling him, if the people of Quraysh and the people of Taif, okay, really mistreated you, okay, Allah is opening the heavens for you to show you all things and show you your position over there. Okay? And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam woke up, he washed wudu, okay, right? And Jibreel told him, do that, wash, okay, do wudu, okay? Wudu, at that time, we don't really know exactly what wudu, but actually he washed everything, you know, body and everything. And he told them just to wear a black hat. Black hat, عمامة سوداء لها ذؤابتان, you know, like the عمامة, like that, okay, and it has two ears like that. They come to your shoulders, okay, and he said it's black. And Jibreel told him, where is this one? And we'll see later on, okay, later on when the open Mecca, Fath open, Fath Mecca, okay, in the year. The eighth year of the Hijrah, that Rasulullah wore this one also. So he wore this one لماما. Okay, and he's getting ready to meet Allah. Then he walked with Jibril. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He walked with Jibril to Al-Kaaba, and then he made tawaf 7 times, and he prayed 2 rak'ah. What kind of pray? Dhikr, ta'abbud ila Allah. Okay, not the way we know it, because the prayer was not really revealed to him yet. Just, you know, he was doing 2 rak'ah in the morning, 2 rak'ah in the evening. Okay, the way, just dhikr and dua and all of that stuff. Okay, like Sayyidina Ibrahim was doing. Okay, and Jibril introduced him to Al-Buraq. Al-Buraq, that's a buraq. This is a carrier, okay, which is going to take him to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. Okay, Al-Buraq. Okay, now, so he said, this is Al-Buraq, this is, Ya Rasulullah, you're going to ride this one and it's going to take you to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. Then Al-Buraq was looking at this one, and he's, you know, so Jibril said, what are you looking at? Do you do that with Rasulullah? خَيْرُ مَنْ رَكِبَكَ يَا بُرَاقُ هُوَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ. خَيْرُ مَنْ, the best who rode you is Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. So that means that he's been ridden by before. Okay, Al-Anbiya was who rode him before. Okay, so he said, okay, this is you hang out, okay, hang on, okay, that's khayru man ride you is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, so let's just give brief account about what is this buraq. Al-buraq is a dab, is an animal, okay, a little bit higher than a donkey, a little bit shorter than a horse. Okay, it's white, he's a male. Okay, له بين يديه, okay, جناحين, 2 wings, he can fly. البراق, الاسم البراق means coming from البرق, thunder, so it means that it's so fast. They say يضع حافره عند منتهى طرفه. So if he's in Mecca, okay, and he just put his first leg over there, it's going to be in the better muscles in no time, faster than the speed of light. Okay, anyway, so anyway ركب النبي على البراق ثم ارتقى به في السماء بعد منتصف الليل. That was after midnight. Okay, and Allah says that ليلا, سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا. ليلا means after midnight. Okay, if it's before that, okay, they say أدلج به, يعني before midnight. So after midnight, Rasulullah rode the buraq, okay, in his way to Masjid al-Aqsa. So now Rasulullah and buraq on top and flying, okay, until they came to al-Madinah, Yathrib at that time. Okay, then Jibril ordered the buraq to descend down, okay, to come down in that place. Okay, so Al-Buraq and Rasulullah went down. Okay, where they get down? Okay, Jibril told Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told him, ha huna ya Muhammad, salli ha huna ya Muhammad. That's in Yathrib or in Al-Madina. Okay, they came down to a place and Jibril told Muhammad, salli ha huna ya Muhammad, هنا سيكون لك مسجد. It's going to be a mosque for you here, and this is exactly where the Masjid al-Nabawi is there. Okay, and this is actually was good, you know, good tidings for Nabi, and that is going to be escape from all the troubles he found from Quraysh and al-Taif. Okay, what is going to happen after that? Okay, they're going to continue. They haven't been yet in Masjid al-Aqsa. So tomorrow they will be in the Masjid al-Aqsa. We'll talk about that tomorrow. Okay? All right. Any questions?
Yes, Doctor. I have questions.
Yes.
Regarding the bones,
Bones, yes.
What I...
Bones.
The bones were used for cleaning the human dirt or something?
Well, I mean, hey, in that time, okay, there was very primitive life there, okay? They didn't really have showers or have bidets to clean themselves and stuff like that. They were just taking anything, stone, you know, the corn thing, you know, just clean themselves, okay? So he, Rasulullah said, you do that, but except don't, if you take a bone, don't clean yourself with the bone. Because the bone is going to be eventually will be the food for the good jinn. Later on, Allah will put meat to them and it's going to feed them. The feed
people, the people had Shemel, they used to live in desert.
Yeah.
Sometimes when they used to go for whatever they used to find, they used to clean themselves.
Yeah.
Some stone, that's dirt, they used to, mostly with dirt. They used to get dirt and used to clean. No water.
Yeah.
Rasulullah said, if you find any bone, don't clean yourself with it. Or rawat. Because this is the food of your brothers from the jinn.
Yes.
Yeah. Regarding you said, because I never heard about what I used to read, that he went to Bayt al-Muqaddas,
Jerusalem.
Bayt al-Muqaddas. Bayt al-Muqaddas.
Directly to heaven. To Bayt al-Muqaddas. But he stopped in Medina. This was before 2 or 3 years. Sheikh Rashid, when he was here, he told this about, because I never read about it, and I told him, well, I just told him, I said, I never read about it. From where did you get this, sentence,
But now, what I read
now
it,
you confirm that.
In their way, in their way, he made
because I was
the
doubtful about him also, frankly speaking. Alhamdulillah.
As Ismail, to be honest, there are too many narrations about this. I've been discussing that with Dr. Esther.
Yeah.
There are too many narrations. Some of them, they said he went to Medina, he was passing by Medina, and he went to Egypt. What is Sayyidina Musa was talking to Allah, passing by Egypt to go there. I don't have any authentic hadith regarding that. To be honest with you, I cannot deny it, I cannot say yes or no.
But doesn't
matter too. Like for example, the Burak male or female,
There are so many controversial things, and people just describing the way they think, okay? And even we're gonna come to a big debate tomorrow, okay? Whether Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes.
هم
طبعا هم استمعوا اليه
القران يعني شافهم هو
شافهم رسول الله الله made them to see them to see them so it's going to be lots of this guy say this say this this say this okay now we're going to say after that when tomorrow we'll talk about those things
يعني احنا احس ما يكون بليف لك الدكتور سير ناو ف the speed of the Burak It's faster than the speed of the light. Means just in no time, the Burak will go from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa.
Yes.
In no time. I don't want to go to Medina and they're going to have GPS. It's done. That's it. I was talking to Jinn sometimes when I read for people. Sometimes I ask Jinn to say La ilaha illa Muhammad Rasulullah. They listen. They say La ilaha Muhammad Rasulullah. Doctor, I saw that. And this, they listen. I said, okay, just to encourage them. They said they're scared. Maybe the one who put the sahib, he put like 10 jinni around him to guard him. If you get out from this body, I'm gonna kill you. That's why sometimes jinni is in the cage. He wanna get out from the body, but he's scared from the jinni. They're gonna kill him. Mm-hmm. And sometimes I encourage them. I tell them, okay, what if you say La ilaha Muhammad Rasulullah from here to Mecca? It takes you, I said, 2 seconds.
Yeah.
The jinn said 2 seconds because it's wind, like rain. 2 seconds. I said, خلاص سيدنا إلى رحمة رسول الله أكبر. You will be there. Your Muslim brothers from Jinn, they're gonna receive you there around the Kaaba. Don't worry, don't scare. They scare because they appoint some Jinn to kill him if he get out from the body of that person. Yes, it's a lot of story. Yeah.
Okay. اللهم إني دعم فأمينه. لبيك وإن قصت القلوب لبيك وإن فاضت الذنوب لبيك إنا عائدون تائبون نادمون لبيك إنا متعبون أجرنا كأننا لم نرى حزنا لبيك ربي وإن لم أكن بين الزحام ملبيا وإن لم أكن بين الحج ملبيا لبيك وإن لم أكن على عرفات مناجيا، لبيك وإن لم أكن بين الصفوف مصليا، لبيك وإن لم أكن بين الحجاج ساعيا. رواكم الله من يد الحبيب صلى الله عليه وسلم، وروى الله قلوبكم ببكاء فرح الإجابة، وحياتكم بالأقدار السعيدة، وأبعد عنكم هم الدنيا وضيق الرزق، وشفع مرضانا ورحم موتانا. نسأل الله تعالى لي ولكم الإجابة، وكل عام وأنتم بخير. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.